Hello and welcome to my channel. As you know, this Kansas 3 case is bizarre. The lawyer of Jordon's contradicted himself. Different stories, different reasonings, different places and doors. I mean, the story goes on. Now, the fifth person's lawyer has a whole different thing to say. Let's take a listen to what the fifth person says. Not only was he not the last one to see these three alive, but just listen.
Christel, I spoke on the phone with that fifth man, and he said without hesitation, he was not the last person to see these three men alive. That is a claim that Jordon Willis's attorney made last night, that today he is walking back. The attorney for this fifth man says his client left the home just after midnight, and when he left, all four men were still there. They were still awake, and they were watching TV.
It's just cover up. Something's wrong with the picture.
Jim McGinney, the uncle of Clayton McGinney, is upset, frustrated, and to this point displeased as the story of what happened on that Sunday night in the Northland gets less clear and more foggy by the day. John Paserno, the attorney for the man who lived at the home, has had an evolving story since Friday. First, he said the fifth person was still there when the three men died. He would change his tune in a News Nation interview hours later.
Before he fell asleep, they were going to leave. He actually escorted them to the door, said their goodbyes, opened the door. He went back on the couch and he crashed.
That statement running contrary to what Paserno told us just hours before. In an exclusive conversation with Fox 4, the fifth man's attorney, Andrew Touch, tells us his client arrived at the home around 7 p.m. He left just after midnight, and when he left, all three men and Jordon Willis were alive and watching Jeopardy. Touch says his client then received a text from Clayton McGinney's fiance and Ricky Johnson's mother on Tuesday inquiring about their whereabouts. At that point, he texted Willis and Johnson. He never got a response. That's another inconsistency. Willis's attorney said his client never received any text, just messages through Facebook.
You heard it. They were all alive and awake and watching Jeopardy. So Jordon and his lawyer have a lot of explaining to do, or all of these people are just making up things and flipping stories. I mean, what is going on? Law enforcement, you need to figure this out. This is very sus. Until next time.